Are you ready to get down to business? Join seasoned entrepreneur, community leader, and Army veteran, Scott Shalom Klein, who will take you behind the scenes with those who work in America's small business scene and speak with leaders making an impact, creating jobs, and telling their story in entrepreneurship.
So let's get down to business.
On AM 560, The Answer, here's your host, Shalom Klein.
And indeed, we are all about small business jobs and entrepreneurship in business. We talk a lot about business here. You're on with Get Down to Business, and I'm your host, Shalom Klein. Remember, you can always download podcasts on my website at syklein.com. And while you're there, don't forget to follow me on Twitter at Shalom Klein. It's going to be a jam-packed week. So let's get started. I'm thrilled to be joined by somebody who for over 30 years has been transforming business aspirations into reality. That's Richard Parker. And he's been garnering a remarkable global impact through his program, How to Buy a Good Business at a Great Price. This program, accompanied by tailored industry and country guides, boasts over 100,000 copies. That's right, 100,000 copies sold across 80 countries, empowering prospective small business owners, which is exactly what I want to talk about today. Richard Parker, welcome to the program.
Thank you. I appreciate you having me.
Absolutely. Richard, I always like to start by getting to know the person behind the microphone. I know you have been a self-described business junkie since childhood. I'd love to hear a little bit about you and your background. Where did this whole entrepreneurship bug get started?
It started very early on. I grew up in Montreal, spent 35 years there before relocating to South Florida, and always had businesses on the go since I'm a little kid. When I talk about a business junkie, I like to, with comedy, say I started my first business at 12 and sold it profitably at 13. And I ended up getting into, I was working for a company in Montreal doing quite well. I made a horrible blunder and bought stock on margin, another company, and pissed away $60,000 when I was 29 years old. I was doing very well. I was making $72,000 a year. And this goes back to 1989, 1990. But I desperately had to figure out a way how to get out of this mess. And even though I loved where I was working, I recognized that the only way I was going to be able to recapture some of that money, and I had a first child on the way, now four children and a grandchild, and realized that the only way I was going to get out of this mess was to go into a business in my own, where I didn't have to, where I didn't have any ceiling on my income. And that's what started my journey of entrepreneurship and acquisitions. And here we are a whole bunch of years later, and I've bought and sold 14 companies. And, you know, with a wide range from $50,000 to a little over $200 million, and spent the last 20 years actually helping people hopefully do exactly what I've been able to accomplish.
I love it. Again, chatting with Richard Parker. And Richard, I'm going to pick your brain on a lot of topics relating to entrepreneurship, but I want to start, as I mentioned in the intro, you run a program called How to Buy a Good Business at a Great Price. And that's what, indeed, every entrepreneur wants to do. So let's start there. You know, you have the option of building a business, or you have the option of buying a business, which is something that you have done. Why have you taken that approach?
Well, very early on when I made my first acquisition, again, it was a very small acquisition based upon the scenario I told you about when I was getting into my own business. And after I started, within very short order, I'm talking within 6-9 months, I realized that in order to grow my business, I could do it organically, which was interesting and romantic, if you will, but recognized that, you know, that a much quicker path would be if I could keep buying businesses and bolt them on to my existing businesses, I could scale my company much quicker than doing it organically. I'm not opposed to startups. I mean, I don't have the stomach to do them anymore. I think if you've got lots of time and lots of money and you want to do a startup or on a part-time basis, a side hustle, it's a good experience. But as far as getting into true entrepreneurship is concerned, you know, the problem with a startup is you don't know anything. Everything sounds wonderful, but nothing is proven. It's all blue sky. And in my experience, you know, revenues always come in twice as slow and expenses are double. And it's very easy to say all these wonderful things are going to happen, but nothing is proven. Whereas if you buy an existing business, a good business, and I don't talk about buying garbage businesses or distressed businesses, and I don't talk about buying great business. I talk about buying good businesses that are in the middle of their history. There you have lots of room and lots of runway to grow them. But if you buy a good business, I mean, in theory, when you do it right and do it the way I show people how to do it, you can get the keys to the place on Monday and take a paycheck on Friday. Everything is in place. You have customers, you have employees, you have suppliers, you have infrastructure. So you have something, a rock solid foundation upon which to build, which in a startup, you have none of that.
Absolutely. So we've talked about the importance of buying. So there's three important words in that little phrase that you have, how to buy a good business at a great price. We talked about buying, talked about a good business. Do you mind defining that a little bit more? What is a good business in 2024?
Well, as far as a good business in 2024 is the same what was a good business in 1924, which is a solid business that has fundamentals in place of which you can apply your best skill set to that business to grow the business. It's I like bland, boring, unsexy businesses that can grow when you match your top skill set to a business that needs that particular skill set to drive the revenue and profits of the business. There's the type of business is less important than the skill set of the individual who's looking to acquire it to make sure they marry it with the right business. If your strength is sales and marketing, you have to acquire a business that needs sales and marketing to drive the revenue and profits. If it's operations or manufacturing or assembling a plant or logistics, that's what's really important. The type of business, in my view anyways, from where I sit, is far less important because I've seen it repeatedly where people have tried to go into a business that they thought they would love or they had a passion about, which was more of a hobby, and they end up screwing it up because what that business needs as the driver of the business doesn't marry to their skill set.
Absolutely. So we talked about buying, we talked about the good business, and now I want to get to the secret over here, the great business. And I don't want to share all the secrets because, of course, we're going to get our listeners in touch with you, but a great price, is that still possible?
Oh, 100%. And I'm, by the way, Shalom, I'm happy to share all the secrets. I got no problem. Of course it's possible as long as you know how to do this. See, a lot of people, the numbers in our industry are terrible, meaning over 90% of the people who begin the search to buy a business never complete a transaction because they have no knowledge, they have no expertise, they have no experience, they have no track record, and they try to go about doing this thinking that this is similar to buying a house or a property, and it's completely different. You need know-how, you need knowledge, and you need to ramp up your expertise quickly in order to do this successfully. But as far as buying at a great price, absolutely. 91% of our clients do this through seller financing. There is some capital that's required. I never would mislead people to think that this concept, you see some of these programs that are shown online, these BS programs that people are promoting to buy these phenomenal businesses for no money down and get 100 years to pay for them. That doesn't exist. I live in the real world and I breathe oxygen from this planet. But again, as I mentioned, 91% of our clients leverage these deals through seller financing. It takes a little bit of capital because you need some down payment. But terms, conditions, I'm very much of the ilk that, hey, Mr. or Mrs. Business Owner, I'll pay your price, you take my terms. And I've had transactions where I've taken, I've had 30-year notes to pay them out. So there's absolutely no question. I apologize for the long-winded answer, but yes, there's absolutely no question that buying a good business at a great price is now probably more achievable than ever because interest rates have gone much higher at the bank. And so that route very often is not a possibility for prospective business owners. They have to go down the road of terms and conditions with the seller, which require, very often are performance-based deals, which we show people how to do, earnouts, which the price is paid based on the business achieving certain milestones over a certain period of time after they take over. So yes, absolutely. The great price piece absolutely hasn't changed. As a matter of fact, I think it's gotten much better now. And I think it's probably the best time in the last 3 decades to buy a business because of some of those components.
I love it. I've been chatting with Richard Parker, who again is the founder of the Business Buyer Resource Center and the author of the How to Buy a Good Business at a Great Price series. Of course, we're going to get all of our listeners in touch with you, Richard. And I have to say that while we've been talking, producer George and I have been engaged in a conversation and we see your energy, we hear your energy more appropriately over the radio. You've been doing this for a while, for 30 plus years, but your excitement remains, which is fantastic. And we only have time for one more question. Richard, not every day in small business and entrepreneurship is rainbows and butterflies. We know that wearing that hat, that very, very important title of entrepreneur, some days has its challenges. What's the most frustrating part of business ownership? And do you have any tips for our listeners?
Yes, you know what? And I use this term pixie dust and unicorns. And so, and also I appreciate your compliments related to my energy, because as my mother said, or Henny Youngman said, I have a great face for radio. But the challenge is what has to happen is there's going to be ups, there's going to be downs, there's going to be peaks, there's going to be valleys. It's part of the equation. The way I try to position this with entrepreneurs is love the process and the process will love you back. Meaning you're going to go through all these things. There is heartburn and it's just inevitable. But if you learn to embrace the uncertainty, if you learn to embrace the challenges, because you're going to come out of the other side so much better, so much bigger, so much faster. To me, those are all the thrilling things of being an entrepreneur. Like to me, going to a job every day is just boring as hell. But as an entrepreneur, the peaks and the valleys, you just have to learn to love them and embrace them. Because if you approach them in a good way and with content and perspective, you're going to come out on the other side in a very positive way.
I love it. It's awesome advice. And I know you've got a lot more where this came from. And I want to make sure our listeners can get in touch with you, Richard Parker. How can they do that?
Very easy. Go to richardparker.com. We have hundreds of free articles, free reports. And if anybody wants to get in touch with me directly, they can do that through our contact us page. So it's pretty simple. richardparker.com.
richardparker.com. And we'll link in our show notes as well. Richard, can't wait to have you back on. A quick break and get down to business. We'll be right back.